The Archbishop of Canterbury once endorsed a Cockney version of the Bible. Is this possible, David Steen?
Why would you need a Cockney version of the Bible?
It was to make the Bible more accessible to the man on the street.
So...
Some blush tamara, stigmata.
George Carey endorsed it in 2001. The feeding of the 5,000 becomes Jesus feeding 5,000 geezers from 5 loaves of Uncle Ned and 2 Lillian Gish. Jesus heals a deaf and dumb man is translated as Jesus heals a mutton Jeff geezer who couldn't rabbit either.
please let this be true. Yeah.
Again, it'd be great if that was true.
Wouldn't it be? I'd buy it. I'd buy one of those.
I think we'd heard about it, though.
You would, wouldn't you? Chas and Dave would have done a CD.
Why is that clever? Rhyming stuff. Why is that good? You're using language to make it unclear. Say what you mean.
Do you think it was to stop the police knowing what you were talking about?
Well, people shouldn't stop the police knowing what they're talking about.
So what are you going to say?
Yeah. I'd like to believe it, but I think it's a lie.
It has to be a lie, doesn't it?
Okay, we'll say lie.
You're saying lie. It is true. Yes, amazingly, it's true, and I have the book here.
Without Adam and Eve, it.
Let me read a bit to you. The Lord's Prayer.
I'm going to hate this, aren't I?
Yes, you are. You are.
Okay, I'll brace myself.
Hello, Dad.
Oh, God.
No, Dad.
Oh, sorry.
Hello, Dad, up there in good old heaven. Your name is well, great and holy, and we respect you, Gov. We hope we can all have a butcher's at heaven and be there as soon as possible, and we want to make you happy, Gov. It is true. When the book came out, it was a massive hit, which is also Cockney rhyming slang.